Hello. Today I'm going to show you how to make a homopolar motor, the simplest kind of motor. In order to make one of these motors, you will need three things. A AA battery, a C battery, or a D battery, depending on what you want to do. A nickel-plated neodymium magnet. It has to be nickel-plated, and it has to be neodymium, or else this won't work. And copper wire, and a lot of patience. So, in order to make one, you have to put the magnet on the bottom of the battery, and then bend the copper so that it can contact the top of the battery and the magnet loosely. This is where the patience comes in. It is tricky in order to get this to work. It took me about a half hour to get this little one to work. It has to be balanced really good. And it'll spin. And that's how the motor works. There's a lot of complicated science in this, so I'm not really gonna describe how you make, or how it works, but just how you make one. Okay, enough of that one, now the more complicated one. This one is mounted on a piece of steel, because once it gets spinning up, it tends to get out of control. It's a more complicated pattern. It took a lot of time to get it balanced right, and so that it contacts. But once you get it going, it's really cool. The problem with these is that they are a direct short on the battery, and if left long enough, they will blow up the battery. Now here's a more complicated one that I made. It has a big magnet in the back that's attracting a smaller magnet mounted on a screw, which is mounted on a battery. And the copper wire is touching the positive terminal on the battery. So for this one to work, you just have to push on that gently so that the copper will contact the screw with the magnet on it. This one is a lot more difficult to get it to go right, but once you do, it's really rewarding because if you can get a screw going 1,000 RPM with only a magnet and some batteries, it's pretty rewarding. Now this one is a little bit more difficult to get to work. You can mount the copper, but that's it's really difficult to get it right. So I just use my fingers to get it to work. Oops. Yeah, difficult. Okay, thanks for watching.